Yesterday, after a brief standoff with lawmakers, President Trump begrudgingly signed a bill approving $900 billion in COVID-19 aid. And I say begrudgingly because days earlier, he blasted leaders for only including a $600 one-time stimulus check. He said he wanted that one-time payment, there it is, to be $2,000, $2,000. And then that's when things kind of got weird, because suddenly Democrats and President Trump, they were on the same page. What? Democrats also wanted $2,000 stimulus checks, and Republicans in Congress were now the odd party out wanting the smaller checks, which brings us to today when the House of Representatives passed a bill increasing those one-time payments to $2,000 like the president asked. Even 44 Republicans voted for it. However, two Democrats did not, and one of them was Congressman Kurt Schrader from Oregon. He explained why he voted no on the House floor earlier today.
This is an ineffective and poorly targeted approach to aiding Americans in distress. It is clearly a last-minute political maneuver by the president and extremists on both sides of the political spectrum who have been largely absent during months of very hard negotiations. They have chosen to tweet their opinions instead of coming to the table to get aid in the hands of Americans and small businesses that need it most.
Once again, there's Twitter in the show, right? So Congressman Schrader is considered a conservative Democrat, and he represents a pretty purple section of Oregon full of both Democrats and Republicans. So frankly, his no vote isn't necessarily shocking, but it's still notable. By the way, it was also futile because the bill passed, but it's got a long road ahead of it. The Senate, of course, still has to approve it. And right now, members don't appear inclined to do so. At least a lot of Republicans don't. Every Democrat in the Senate does support this bill, but it's probably not going to get it to the 60 votes which it would need to pass. So if the Senate shoots it down this week, people who make $75,000 or less will still get that $600 stimulus check along with the rest of the COVID relief in that package. But if the Senate goes ahead and passes this extra money and President Trump signs it, you might start your new year with $2,000 instead of $600.